We are here today to celebrate and share the glorious actions God is about to perform. The act in which He converts their love for one another into the holy and sacred state of marriage. It is designed to unite two sympathies and hopes into one, and it rests upon the mutual confidence and devotion of husband and wife. Being assured that your love for each other and your choice in one another as lifelong companions are in God's will and have your family's blessing, I ask now, who gives this woman to be married to this man? Every day you learn to receive love and learn to give love. Find things within yourself and then share them with each other. Do not fear this love. Have an open heart and a sincere mind. Be sincerely interested in each other's happiness. Be constant and consistent in your love for each other. From this comes security and strength. Try to commit yourself fully and freely to each other. Before you are joined in marriage, I am reminding you of the serious and binding nature of the relationship you're about to enter. Marriage, as most of us understand it, is the commitment of a man to a woman and of a woman to a man. It is entered into with the firm intention that it will last a life. The Apostle Paul compared the relationship between a husband and wife to that between Christ and the church. Marriage is a decision of two individuals to share the same type of pure Christian love described by Paul. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It is not boast. It is not rude. It is not self-serving. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always deserves. Love never fails. Terry and Melissa, do you promise to be each other's constant friends, faithful partner, and love from this day forward? In the presence of God and your family and friends, state that you offer your solemn vow to be a faithful partner in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, in joy as well as in sorrow. Do you promise to love unconditionally and to support one another in your goals, to honor and respect, to laugh with and cry with, and to cherish for as long as you long both shall live? Each of you have rings. These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end. May these rings always remind you of the vows you're taking. Please join me in prayer. Lord, bless and consecrate Terry and Melissa and their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of their faith they have for each other and a reminder that true love like these rings has no end. May they abide in your peace and continue in your favor until life ends. Through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Terry, I have not the right to bind thee to Melissa. Only you have this right. If it be your wish, say so at this time and place your ring in her hand. Melissa, if it be your wish for Terry to be bound to you, place the ring on his finger. Melissa, I have not the right to bind you to Terry. Only you have this right. If it be your wish, say so at this time and place your ring in his hand. Terry, if it be your wish for Melissa to be bound to you, place the ring on her finger. Melissa and Terry, today you join your two separate lives together. The two separate bottles of sand symbolize your separate lives, separate families, and separate sets of friends. They represent all that you are and all that you will ever be as individuals. As these two containers stand or poured into the third, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but they will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can no longer be separated and poured again into separate containers, so will your marriage be. Thank you. Rosa, I give you this challenge, that you love each other with an encompassing spectrum of love. Let there be expressions of love and actions and words, as well as accompanying silence. Be mindful of each other's needs. Talk when the other needs to hear. Listen when the other needs to be heard. And hold when the other needs to be held. And lastly, open yourselves to the divine love which has brought you here today and woven the tapestry of your union, and honor it with faith, hope, and love, knowing that the greatest of these is love. Will you accept this challenge? As you have consented together to be bound to one another in lawful marriage, you have made special promises today, which have been made by taking vows and exchanging rings, blending your families. I ask now that you seal these promises, staying with the kiss. I pronounce you to be husband and wife. Have a good time for reception.
Thank you.